Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Yes, we have got the Note 9 here, the powerful beast, and I'm really excited to test all the features and functions that Note 9 has to offer. And I'm also a fan of Note series. I've been using all their Note series every year when it comes out, because it has got pretty much anything that you can ask for from a mobile phone. So that's how awesome the Note series have been. And in today's video, if you have bought the new Note 9 and you don't know how to set up it for the first time, this video will really help you. And if you are new to my channel, hit that subscribe button and do like this video if you find it helpful. Also guys, excuse my voice, I'm feeling a bit cold today. I had to make this video on Note 9's first boot because I'll be setting this mobile as my daily driver. I'll be shifting it from OnePlus 6, and we will look at how it compares with the OnePlus 6 and other mobiles as well in the upcoming days. And you can also leave me comment in the comment section there, what videos would you like to see about this Note 9 or OnePlus 6 comparison and all sorts of that. Alright then, let's go ahead and power on this beast for the very first time on this channel. So here's the Samsung Galaxy Note 9 secured by Knox. This secured by Knox feature is really appreciated, and a lot of users don't know how the Knox feature is used. I'll also be making a video about that separately in future, so stay tuned. Because the Knox offers you very private and very secured features, secured option where you can store your private documents and all sorts of that. So that's very helpful, and a lot of people don't know about that. So here's the startup screen. You can basically select any language you want as an entire interface. So you can select it right away from here. For now we will choose the English United Kingdom. And once I tap on that arrow mark. So if you haven't inserted the SIM card yet, you can actually take the rejector pin, and here it is located. You just tap on that and remove it and insert your SIM card, and also push it back so that it recognizes as a network, and we can also follow up these steps. Otherwise you can also skip that. You can later insert your SIM card as well. And here you have to connect to Wi-Fi. If you have got any Wi-Fi network, you can connect it right away. If you don't have any internet connection, you can just tap on next so that it will skip automatically. Later you can obviously connect to the internet. So once you have connected to the internet, just tap on next here. And once you have tapped on next, you got to agree to their terms and conditions. So end user license agreement, pretty much you have to tap on each and everything. Privacy policy, diagnostic data, this is optional actually. So consent to provide diagnostic and usage data. So pretty much they will extract some usage data so that you'll get future updates based on how your device is performing and all sorts of that. For now we will just leave it. Marketing information, if you want you can also enable these, otherwise you can also disable it, it depends on your preference. So for now we will just enable it, enable everything. I've read and agree to all of the above. And once you do that, checking for updates, if there is any update it will notify here. As you can see right out of the box, 62% is the battery left, and here's the sign in information for Google. If I've got account, you can sign in to the Google. So I've got the account, I'll just sign in to my Google account. Otherwise you can also skip if you don't have the Google account yet and you later want to set up that. You can also always skip and just go forward with the steps. And here you can enter your name. Let's say we shall type Big Geek, or pretty much any name if you want to give your device, you can do that. Set up intelligence scan, set up face recognition, set up iris scanner, set up fingerprint scanner, set up PIN, pattern or password. For now we will say no thank you. You can also set up intelligence scan, that means it uses face as well as iris recognition sensor from that together, and it will recognize to scan intelligently and unlock the device. So we can set it up this later as well. So for now we will just tap on no thank you and move it on, say skip anyway. And here helps find location, we will disable this. You can always enable all those things in the notification center. For now if you keep enabling all those, it will eat up your battery a lot. So for now we will just disable and tap on I agree, and adding the finishing touches. This may take a minute or two. So here's the Samsung account. So if you have got Samsung account, you can sign in, otherwise you can always create account. I suggest you create account for Samsung and then sign in. So for now we will skip from Samsung Cloud. From your old device, don't restore. So if you have got data, if you are transferring your data from your older phone to this phone, you can always use these features. Otherwise you can later also import the data from your older phones. For now we will say don't restore and set up this mobile as a new one. So extend your battery life on. So it has automatically turned it on. That means it will forcefully stop the applications which are not used for more than 3 days. That's a helpful thing to extend the battery life. And secure your stuff. So you have got the secure folder. Let's turn it on. So it is on now. And once you do that, just tap on finish. And all done, your phone is ready to use. So this is the home screen of the new Galaxy Note 9. So quite a shady, quite a gradient one wallpaper they have chosen. So this is the 6.4 inch screen you have got here. Let's see what is updating. Samsung email is updating, completing setup. And once we move to the settings over here, so let's move to the about section, software update. So if there is any update, you will be notified over here. About phone, so this is basically running 9.5 Samsung Experience version, Android version 8.1. So Android security patch is updated to August 2018, and this is pretty much it. Let's quickly jump into the camera interface and see how the beast looks upon. So this is the camera interface. Let me bring this plant quickly. So this is the camera interface. You have got the live focus to basically blur the background. Look how awesome it looks. You can pretty much blur the background. You have got the level here as well. So you have got the pro mode, which we all are excited for. I'll be testing it very thoroughly. Stay tuned on my channel. And you've got the super slow motion, AR emoji, hyperlapse, and all sorts of that. So obviously this is a beast, and everything will be here on the Note 9. So we'll be looking into more very soon. Stay tuned on my channel. Hit that subscribe button. And see you all in another video. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.